just shared with me something really, really cool. Ladies and gentlemen, we are live right now on Twitch.
YouTube.
We are live.
YouTube.
Yes, do you turn around and look at the camera and say hello to everybody out there?
Yo, partners in chat.
You are live tonight. And as long as festivals don't beat us, this is all I can hear that. It's all the community. We're on Twitch and we are on YouTube now.
Hey. We're
YouTube, and we're on Facebook. You guys are live everywhere. Mobile territory. Very, very, very cool stuff. So you guys enjoy Broken Vessel? Oh, yeah, that was incredible stuff. You guys have fun? Yeah. All right, my friend, if you haven't heard me, because I have listened to your teasers about a dozen times already. That's right. This guy, I love your teasers. And this is going to be fun. So ladies and gentlemen, make some noise for the one who knows. He's hanging out with Kent Jones. This is Sig Dick's band. How y'all doing today? Everybody good? Everybody okay?
Alright. So
come get started.
Don't you never forget me.
Yeah.
First time doing this song, so y'all should feel special.
Y'all should feel special. Let's go. Count them up. Any moment, we gonna 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 count them up. Can I get a one? And can I get a two? And can I get a three? The three to the four.
Thank you.
It's dedicated to anybody just lost somebody or anybody that is praying for somebody right now. Pastor Barry, we dedicate this song to you, okay? This song is called Glory After This, and I wrote this song during a very difficult time in my life, so I hope it blesses somebody. Let's go.
I appreciate y'all. I love y'all. And most importantly, family now.
Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for these three.
Thank you.
All right, hey guys, let's start bringing it in. Bring it back up here. Come on, come on, come on. Everybody come on up front. Gospel Mission Youth Group, you have represented tonight. You have, you have. We didn't need no other youth group because you straight up brought. See, that's right, that's right. And guys, I can't tell you enough how much I've heard in the last 15 minutes, how much this group loved all three of you. So, fantastic. Fantastic. So check out, we are on Facebook, we are on Martini Photographics, on Twitch. What are we on Twitch? What is this handle? Martini Media. And on YouTube, we are live right now to the YouTube world on Martini Media as well. Three channels live. So like I said, I'm getting messages, people are watching, so which is really, really cool. All right. So, ladies and gentlemen, this is one of the most exciting things for me because for the last 15, 20 years, I've gotten to introduce a lot of bands, a lot of artists, a lot of youth slams. I mean, if you remember, just a year ago, we had Rhett Walker here.
Heck yeah, I remember that.
But here's the thing.
Now, I don't think they heard you. About a year ago, you had Rhett Walker here.
So, and what's cool is, you know, we talk about it a lot, but Rhett hadn't really taken off at that point. I was about to say, if you haven't been following this past year, Rhett's taken off. Ladies and gentlemen, I think you have some incredible artists in this room that is going next level. So, I mean, it's going to be big. And this next group is not just a bunch of musicians. This is true, incredible. Like Michaela and I love you guys because you are just.
It's Ohana.
It's Ohana. That's right. That's right. Did it. Barney, did I get that right? Ohana. It's Ohana. It's Ohana. Akun Mata. There we go. So, we absolutely love these guys. We talk. Pretty much almost, if not every week, every other week. These are very, very special people to me. And ladies and gentlemen, the worship set that you prepared for tonight is incredible. I want you to show the great same energy that you've already brought. And let's show the Facebook world, YouTube world, and Twitch world how Gospel Mission worships our incredible Savior. Amen?
Amen.
All right, so with that said, some of the most incredible people that I've ever met. Ladies and gentlemen, Judah Firstman.
So I think we all right now deserve to look at the camera real quick. And Michaela and Anna, we love you guys. We miss you. We are going to lift you guys up in prayer. And if you guys could just join me in prayer right now, all right? If you guys just want to like hold your hands or something to get, you know, hold hands with people and everything and just love each other. Because that's what we're here to do tonight. We're here to unite as one body tonight, right? We are going to worship our Lord and Savior. And I hope tonight you can honestly, deep down, leave here knowing the Savior that we're singing on tonight, all right? Lord and Heavenly Father, just thank you so much for each and every person that was here tonight. God, just thank you so much for your spirit to just go through this whole building. God, and the artists that came all the way from St. Louis that are dear friends of ours, Quality Gospel, God, just be with them as they continue to spread your word. God, Michaela and Anna, you are with them right now. God, that you are circling them right now. God, that you're giving them comfort right now. God, that you're giving Brother Barry comfort right now. God, that you're giving the family of Gospel Mission comfort right now. God, that we just call upon your name as we worship you. And all God's people said, amen. Are you guys ready to raise a hallelujah tonight? I want to hear you. I said, are you ready to raise a hallelujah tonight?
Oh,
Put those hands up in the air. Come on. You know, there's only a whole world watching this right now. We got to participate. Come on.
If you're the one who wants me, if you're so good to me, you are the king of the kings. Like you were, and now you're ready to steal the throne of all the things. And if you say it's crying out, we're joining the minds, we sing glory to God. Forever, long
Having a good time so far, right? We serve an everlasting God. You believe that in all your heart here tonight, right? That's going to be a lot louder than that. We serve an everlasting God of everlasting living in your lives.
All right.
So we're gonna do 1, 2, 3. She's your cheerleader. and gentlemen, from Bluford, Illinois, and also this, this is Mr. Paul Patrick. So this young lady to my right, your left, I'm not going to give a hard time. For 23 years, she's been my wife, and I know her, guys. But that young lady right there with the beautiful purple lace, and Rhett Walker signed it, by the way. Did you see that up there? Yeah, Rhett Walker signed that. And you guys came and seen this on that show, so we appreciate you. Tell you what, give that young lady a round of applause. That's my wife. We are from Mount Vernon, Illinois area, and my name is Ryan Overby. It is so glad to be here. You guys are one of my favorite places to come. When you walk in this place, you can just feel love. And I truly mean that. I really, truly mean that. We all talk about it all the way here. But I got a question. How many, and you all aren't old enough, but you all back there are, how many like 1973 rock and roll? Anyone? Oh, I'm seeing hands all over the place. Well, Paul likes rock and roll. So we're gonna have to beat Paul. So I got another question. How many like a little harder edge rock? Like maybe 1990 era?
Yeah!
Well, we're not that good. But we will come really close here, right? So should we do it? Should we really do it? So we're going to do a little different flair and a little stuff like this.
Right now,
So we're going to sing this song. I'm not going to say what we're talking about. What we're going to do. We are here to live our lives. Those ones were heard. Those were 5 hours over there. We're going to sing the blessings of the enemy. We're going to come out of that song. Thank you.
We did really realize it. And
But now we bring up, so some this year, we bring up a subject matter each time. We've got an SEC before. What do you think SEC is? A subject matter agreement for awareness. So it's all anti-bullying, right? It's about building on how to control this world. And it's so easy to now make things. We all got those iPads. I mean, you guys just told me that iPads, right? Or your flash phone, right? So when you hit that send button, you're going to be able to send a text and you're like, you hear that? Yeah. Sometimes it's an accident, but sometimes if you really at that moment you think that you're assistant, it's kind of an issue because I think they remember you were meaning to send that button, right? You were really meaning at that moment when you're doing it. And I want to tell you something, that is a horrible way. And I think what we need to do is we need to think about what effects can actually have, all right? The effects can be life-threatening. And this year, I told some stuff about that. That's something that we were able to do. That's a rare beautiful first man. We can get out of state names without that message. Of just the awareness of bullying to the top level. The awareness that it can lead to suicidal thoughts to those victims. I want you guys to think of something right now. So however many people have ever, like, cut themselves when you have a scar on your body somewhere? You guys are like, yeah, so I'm going to tell you something. If I was to pick on you and I'd ask you about that scar, I'm not going to. But if I asked if you would know every detail, you would know what happened. You would know how deep it was cut. You would know every intricate detail of that moment. You could probably tell me everything. Oh, yeah, well, I was doing this on this day at this time, and I got 24 stitches. When you hit that send button in that hateful way, when you send that message that's very hurtful to someone, 3 years from now, they know exactly the moment in time they received it. They know the moment in time that they read it. They remember the moment in time of how deep it cut and how it tore them down. And folks, we as a band, and I can tell you, I can speak for all these artists that were here today, we all stand for love, we stand for joy, and the message of hope. And I'm going to tell you something right now. When you are in a hurtful sense like that, you are absent of one, you are absent of all three of them. Amen? So we unfortunately do live in a world that does want to profile each and every one of you guys, and I'm sorry for that. But I'll tell you what, we'll talk about that in a minute because we got this brand new song that we're going to do for you. That's actually new this year, but you guys have heard it. That we'll be able to talk a little bit more about it. But unfortunately, we live in a world that judges. They judge because you don't have a lot of shoes. They judge because they got the wrong shirt on. You judge because you look different. Your hair is different. It's not the right color for the moment. It's whatever that is. You don't have enough money. You have too much money. It's like nothing is ever perfect. But I'm going to tell you right now, those are lies. All right? God loves each and every one of you equally and just as you are. And always remember that. So if you take nothing away from the day, love you and understand that God loves you just the way you are. All right? And we got the song and we dedicate to anybody that's ever been picked on, that's ever been told that, right? And this song is called Fear is a Liar. You guys know that song? So we're going to sing that together. Right? We're going to sing it together. Together. Here we go.
Strong enough to put up. Sign language on this, and they actually did it in front of this scary crowd in front of Walmart.
So I want to encourage you guys, right? This is a really important series. Say anything. That's cool, right? That's cool. Give her a round. All right, I think it's time for some crickets, don't you think?
Oh, yeah.
I didn't hear you. 1, 2, 3. Tells me that somebody don't want us to play this song, and we're going to do it anyway. All right. Are we ready for some crickets this time? I hate it. I'm here.
You guys enjoyed Judah First? Yeah. Awesome, awesome. Hey, I'm going to pull up a couple things real fast. So, Miss Riley, can you put me up on the screen? It's the other PowerPoint. Grayson's all over it. You guys grab a seat where you're at real fast. We'll be fast. Promise you, I'm not going to be long-winded tonight, but I do want to hit a couple of things. Hi, Mark. Man, I've missed you.
Enjoy it, buddy.
So, I put together a thing called the Reluctant Candidate because I've been thinking this week longer than this week. I'm gonna be honest with you guys. You know, I've been one of those that have always kind of shied away, and you know, but you go ahead, Grace, and you pull up that first slide. You know, and that's why I dug out these verses out of Exodus, where Moses says, "Who me? I'm a nobody. How many in here have not done something that you had the opportunity to do because, one, you didn't think you were good enough, you didn't think you could do it? You got any hands on that one?" So here's the thing, guys. I want you to know, Moses, like one of the heroes in the Bible, Moses, said the same thing. Who me? I'm a nobody. God answers it real simple. I'll go with you. He says in Exodus 3:11, Moses protested to God, "Who am I to appear before Pharaoh? Who am I to lead the people of Israel out of Egypt?" Ladies and gentlemen, every one of you have an opportunity to do something awesome. And I promise you this, you might not know it, but tonight, you've impacted people's lives. With us being all over, you know, everywhere on social media and the internet tonight, people have watched how you worship. I don't know, Ryan, if you noticed those last couple songs when you guys were all grouped up, I was telling some people, man, you know, you see the Holy Spirit rocking with you guys. And I want you guys to know, don't think you don't have that skill or that talent to make a difference. Moses, that's the same thing. And God said, I'm going to go with you.
I will be with you. Guys, I am horrible at math. Horrible. So when you asked your math question earlier in the evening, you know, I was already like shying away in the corner. You know, I always would get a little nervous about this. And, you know, the thing is you know, you look at this, these hard questions, how am I going to answer it? I don't know what I'm going to say. I don't know what I'm going to do. I don't know the Bible. You know what's cool is God answers Moses right back and he says, "Tell them my special name, I am." Next to this 3, it says that Moses protested, "If I go to the people of Israel and tell them the God of your ancestors has sent me to you, they will ask me, what is his name? And what should I tell them?" God replied to Moses, "I am who I am. Say this to the people of Israel, I am, has sent me to you." God also said to Moses, "Say this to the people of Israel, Yahweh, the God of your ancestors, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, the God of Jacob, has sent me to you. Don't shy away because you might not know the answer." You know, I think I've shared it a couple of times here with you guys. You know, one of my mentors told me one of the coolest things. He said, when you get to a spot and you don't know how to share the word of God with somebody, all you do is you tell them what Jesus done in your life. You don't have to hit them with Bible verses or anything. Tell them how God changed you. What impact did Jesus have in your life? And I have a feeling everybody in this room has a cool testimony, right? I can almost guarantee that you know, you listen to the stories and you can see what God's done and that impact. Ms. Riley, you can head on to the next one. You ever said this one? Nobody's going to listen to me. Yeah. I've said this one, guys. You know, why be involved? Why jump out there? Nobody's going to listen to me. Why lead this trip? Nobody's going to listen. And God has one of the coolest answers out there. But Moses protested again. What if they won't believe me or listen to me? What if they say the Lord never appeared to you? Then the Lord asked him, "What is that in your hand?" "A shepherd's staff," Moses replied. "Throw it down on the ground," the Lord told him. So Moses threw down the staff and turned it into a snake. Moses jumped back. Then the Lord told him, reach out and grab its tail. So Moses reached out and grabbed it, and it turned back into the shepherd's staff in his hand. Perform this sign, the Lord told him. Then they will believe that the Lord, the God of their ancestors, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, the God of Jacob, really has appeared to you. Then the Lord said to Moses, now put your hand inside your cloak. So Moses put his hand inside his cloak, and when he took it out again, his hand was white as snow with a severe skin disease. Now put your hand back into your cloak, the Lord said. So Moses put his hand back in, and when he took it out again, it was healthy as the rest of his body. The Lord said to Moses, if they do not believe you and are not convinced by the first miraculous sign, they will be convinced by the second. And if they don't believe you or listen to you even after these two signs, then take water from the Nile River and pour it on the dry ground. When you do, the water from the Nile will turn to blood on the ground. Basically, God's telling Moses, don't be afraid. Be that difference maker, guys. Be that difference maker in people around you. I promise you this, somebody at your school looks up to you. You might not know it. They're watching you. What is your action showing them? What is your behavior telling them? What type of influence are you having? We need to be able to show Christ in our everything. So tonight we're going to open up an altar call for you guys. So we got a prayer cloth or prayer cloth on the back wall. We've got an altar. You've got adults all over the room. And here's the thing, guys. And you know, we laugh, and I've made this statement a few times. But, yeah, if you get hit by a Mack truck, you know where you're going. If you die tonight, is it heaven or hell? And if you're not sure, and you've got some questions, come find one of us adults. Come talk to us. Don't leave here without knowing. Altars are going to be open. My family here is going to be leading worship. Next 3 minutes, it's you and Jesus time. Everybody back up.